Greetings, true believers, and welcome to another inspiring episode of History of the Marvel Universe. Today we're going over some of the individuals who have taken over the identity of Captain America. There are some that predate Steve Rogers, notably his ancestor with the same name who fought in the Revolutionary War, as well as Isaiah Bradley, the black Captain America who was used as a test subject for the Super Soldier Serum. There are also various futures where others have taken up the identity, such as Danielle Cage, the daughter of Luke Cage and Jessica Jones, and Roberta Mendez, the Captain America of the year 2099. And of course, there are any number of imposters, android duplicates, evil doppelgangers, and various alternate universe counterparts. But today we're focusing on those who have taken up the shield during the times when Steve Rogers was unable or unwilling. The first case of this was, of course, after Rogers and his partner Bucky were lost and presumed dead during the final year of World War II. In order to cover up the disappearance of Captain America, William Naslund was chosen by President Truman to take over the role. Naslund had previously shown his worth as a masked crusader, calling himself the Spirit of 76. In addition, a boy named Fred Davis filled in for Bucky. Together, they joined forces with several of Cap's allies as members of the All-Winner Squad. However, Naslund's tenure was a short one, as he was killed in action in the summer of 1946. Following this, the role was taken over by Jeffrey Mace, formerly the Patriot. As the Patriot, Mace was a member of the Liberty Legion and also fought alongside Steve Rogers and William Naslund against the Red Skull. After Naslund's death, Mace took his place on the All-Winner Squad and served as Captain America until 1950, when he formally retired from the role to focus on his career as a journalist. The name then went unused until 1953, when it was taken up by a man named William Burnside. Despite the government's attempts to cover up the disappearance of the original Captain America, rumors of his death circulated as early as 1945. Teenage William Burnside was devastated, and his childlike reverence of Captain America grew into an unhealthy obsession. Then, in early 1953, while studying German files from the war, Burnside discovered what he believed to be the formula for the Super Soldier Serum. He volunteered to become the new Captain America, even going as far as changing his name and surgically transforming himself into a dead ringer for Steve Rogers. However, with the end of the Korean War, the US government decided against placing someone else in that role. Dejected, the fake Rogers instead became a history teacher at the Lee School, where he befriended another Cap fanatic named Jack Monroe. Then, when the second Red Skull emerged, fighting on behalf of Soviet Russia, Burnside and Monroe injected themselves with the Super Soldier Serum and adopted the identities of Captain America and Bucky. For the next 2 years, Burnside acted as an unauthorized Captain America and battled communist forces. However, the process Burnside had used to become a super soldier was incomplete, and coupled with his own instability, he grew more paranoid, racist, and violent. Soon after, he was captured by the authorities and placed into cryogenic suspension. The name Captain America then went unused for years until the Marvel Age of Heroes arrived. At one point, the legend of World War II seemed to have returned, but this turned out to be the criminal acrobat Carl Zante and was apprehended by Johnny Storm, the modern Human Torch. But it was soon after this that the real Captain America was found and recovered by the Avengers. Steve Rogers joined the modern super team and resumed his position as Captain America. However, several years later, he began to lose faith in the Stars and Stripes. When he discovered that the leader of the villainous Secret Empire was in fact the President of the United States. After witnessing the leader of the free world shoot himself before his very eyes, Rogers retired, unable to represent a system he no longer believed in, instead taking up the costumed identity of Nomad. Others attempted to fill his role, such as baseball player Bob Russo and notorious biker Scar Turpin, but neither lasted more than a single outing before giving up. A young man named Roscoe Simons was more sincere and determined in his attempt to fill Roger's shoes, but he was brutally killed and strung up by the original Red Skull as a warning to anybody else who would dare to wear that costume. Determined to prevent something like that from happening again, Steve Rogers once again donned the guise of Captain America, swearing to be vigilant in fighting both external threats like the Red Skull and also corruption from within. However, several years later, Rogers was indicted by the newly formed Commission on Superhuman Activities. Since the identity of Captain America was created and owned by the US government, the CSA expected Rogers to work directly for them, no longer allowing him to operate independently. Unable to agree to their terms, Rogers turned in his shield and formally resigned once again. This time, his official replacement was a man named John Walker. Previously the glory-seeking vigilante known as the Super Patriot, Walker was even stronger than Rogers due to receiving enhancement from the Power Broker. As Captain America, Walker was trained in the use of his shield by Taskmaster and partnered with Lamar Hoskins, who later took up the name Battlestar. Rogers, meanwhile, adopted a new black costume and simply called himself the Captain. However, it turns out the Red Skull was manipulating the CSA behind the scenes, leading to a fight between the two captains. But after Rogers successfully exposed the Skull's machinations, he was given the opportunity to become Captain America again, this time on his own terms. While he initially refused, Walker insisted that Rogers return to the role. After this, John Walker donned the black costume and became known as US Agent. Rogers then continued to operate as Captain America until he was assassinated at the end of the first superhero Civil War. Tony Stark asked Clint Barton, the Avenger known as Hawkeye, to carry the shield as he was one of the few people who could wield it effectively. However, Barton refused to enforce the Superhuman Registration Act and returned the costume after wearing it a single time. It was also around this time that Frank Castle, otherwise known as the Punisher, used a modified version of the costume to battle a new hate monger. Of course, this was completely unsanctioned, and Castle was confronted by Cap's old partner, Bucky Barnes. After a brief scuffle, Castle turned over his suit to Barnes, abandoning any ideas of becoming a new Captain America. Fittingly enough, it was Barnes himself who officially filled the role next with a modified costume of his own. Of course, it was soon discovered that Rogers wasn't truly dead and he inevitably returned. But Steve was so impressed with Bucky's performance in the role that he asked him to continue it. But Barnes was later arrested by Russian authorities for crimes committed as the Winter Soldier. While Bucky was in a Russian gulag, David Rickford, a former Special Forces soldier who had been enhanced by the Power Broker, attempted to take over the role of Captain America. However, Rickford was captured by Advanced Idea Mechanics and had to be rescued by Steve Rogers on his first day. Remembering what happened to Roscoe Simons, Rogers convinced Rickford to quit. And even after briefly returning to the role of Captain America, sometime after this, Bucky Barnes returned to the shadows to work as a covert operative for Nick Fury. And Steve Rogers took up the shield once again. Sometime after this, during a battle with the villain known as the Iron Nail, Rogers was struck with a poison that neutralized the Super Soldier serum in his body. This caused him to rapidly age as his many years suddenly caught up with him. Rogers retired again, but this time he was able to choose his own successor. And the one he chose was Sam Wilson, who had been Steve's friend and ally for many years as the high-flying Falcon. Wilson proved to be a controversial choice among many Americans, but despite this, he acted with compassion and integrity in his quest to do what was right. During this time, Rogers had his youth and strength restored to him by the sentient cosmic cube, Kobik. And so for a time, both Rogers and Wilson wore the title of Captain America. However, Rogers' reinvigoration was also a part of a scheme by the Red Skull to use the Cosmic Cube to turn Captain America into a Hydra sleeper agent. This culminated in a Hydra takeover of the United States with Rogers at the head. But this Hydra loyalist version of Captain America was a creation of Kobik, while a memory of the real Rogers was trapped within her mindscape. Fortunately, with the help of his old friend Bucky, the real Rogers was able to return as an independent entity and defeated his fascist counterpart. Knowing that his friend would need to work hard to win back the trust of the people, Wilson gave the shield back to Rogers, leaving only one Captain America once again. While Wilson returned to his identity as the Falcon and turned his focus to street-level conflicts and helping people in need. And that's pretty much everybody who has replaced Steve Rogers as Captain America. But thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like, share the video, and subscribe for more marvelous content. Be sure to leave a comment letting me know who your favorite version of Captain America is, and as always, the issues referenced in this video are listed in the description below if you would like to read them for yourself, as well as links to other places you can find me, including my Patreon page, where for only a dollar a month you can get your name in these special thanks here. So until next time, true believers, Excelsior!